All right, what's up, guys? So we are getting ready to get going here with FTX 816 Task Force Bravo. Gonna be Zeusing tonight, myself and Staff Sergeant Munson. I am doing good, man. I've been doing a lot of Zeusing today, but doing good. Hopefully this will be a good FTX for the guys. Hopefully they'll learn a lot from it, as that is what this is all about. Yes and no, as far as a big mission. It'll be, tonight's an FTX, so it'll be primarily about training. So the first little bit, they will be doing a sand table exercise and training on some stuff. And then they'll come out and actually do the exercise and, you know, make critiques and possibly run it again, depending upon how it goes and so on. All right, how are you doing, Munson?
Got some good stuff down at the moment.
All right.
Oh god, don't blow up. Okay. There
we go. All right, I'm actually going to need you to log into admin here in just a minute so you can keep track of server performance and take care of people logging in with fucked up mods. So I'm gonna log out and then I'm gonna give you the password and shit, and I'll just send it to you on Steam.
Roger.
Taco, I appreciate it, brother. As always, you know there's no actual admission fee, right? Say again. You do pound login and then the password. All right, you're logged in. Then do the monitor, pound monitor 20, and it's not going to pop up right away. Like, it'll take a second for the stats to pop up.
Charlie on for 70.
Just give it time. Yeah.
There's somebody.
Whoa, yep, whoa. Go ahead and go to your map, go to your player list, and remove him. I will find him in TeamSpeak and let him know. The fuck is he at?
There he is, got him.
You found him in TeamSpeak?
Yep.
Alright, send him a message, let him know his CBA is outdated. Alright, did the server performance thing pop up yet?
Nope.
Alright, just log out of admin. I'll take care of it for now. We'll have to figure that out later. Just do pound log out.
Done.
Alright. Alright, just a second, guys. Obviously, I can't let you see what the passwords are. Yeah, Zeus isn't too bad once you figure out kind of the basics of it. It does take some time to learn the little intricacies of it and just the tiny little tips and tricks and shit. I'm not really sure what you mean about chat disabled. All right, should be good now. And why the fuck do I not have Zeus access now? God damn it. I'm going to have to log out and log back in. I'll be right back.
Roger.
Alright, give me just a second here, guys. Something's going on with fucking Zeus access. All right, and still don't have a goddamn access. Oh, this is a bit of a pain in the ass. Very sorry, guys.
There we go.
A little off, though. Tilde, it's above 10.
Well, hopefully you guys like my stream starting soon screen. All right. Well, things may be changing here in a moment. Captain?
Yeah.
Having issues with Zeus access. I now have no Zeus access. Doesn't matter if I'm in admin or if I disconnect and reconnect, I cannot get into Zeus.
What?
Yeah, I don't know. Sergeant Munson's able to get in there, but I cannot. I was, and then I logged out of admin to have him log in there to monitor server performance. And once I did that, I can't get into Zeus.
Not even in the other Zeus slots?
Negative.
Did you try turning it off and back on again?
Yes. Alright, give me just a second to unfuck this, guys.
Are you still talking?
Alright guys, so what we're going to do is restart the mission here to try and unfuck it, see if that helps. So I'm going to have to go back to the fucking starting soon screen again and restart it and get this going. So it'll be just a couple minutes and hopefully it should be unfucked. All right, we'll get this going in just a moment, guys. All right, I have Zeus access again. Thank the Lord.
Radio check 121.
All right, so we'll get our radios set.
I wish every loading was this quiet and this calm. Keep it up, Havoc 2.
Still have Zeus access? Yes.
Okay. Yep. Is everything fucking gone?
Yes.
Okay. God damn it.
Still got plenty of time.
Alright. Well, it's just I made it fucking badass.
Then make it badass again.
Oh, god damn it. And that just happened. Fucking hell.
Dagger, this is 27, Lima Charlie, and point one over.
Oops.
Kill radio check on 7-0.
Just,
Lima Charlie,
start building. I'm not gonna put anything down.
Okay, Roger. I kinda saw the shit you already did anyway. So.
Yeah, just put that other block over there that I had. But build everything, put all the units down. Remember, you'll have to control the units. I can't control the ones that you put down.
Roger. I'll put random shit down, like helicopters and shit. They'll all be empty and stuff, so. You don't gotta worry about any crazy shit going down.
Yeah, just make sure you take the fuel out of them.
Squad leaders, I'm going to say this to you one more time. Make sure you guys are on Whisper.
The op for tonight is the Jadaki or whatever surgeons, these guys here.
Radio check frequency 120.
24 right, 727 Charlie Misnet over.
Copy out.
Habit 2 is Habit 2 3 radio check on 120.0 over. 23, this is 27 Lima Charlie. Over. Roger out.
Let's see.
Havoc 2, this is 2-1 on 120, radio check.
2-1, this is 2-7, Lima Charlie.
Yeah, brother, it was FUBAR there for a second. Copy that. I don't know what the fuck the issue was. I couldn't get Zeus access, but all good now.
All squads on frequency 120, this is Havoc 2-7. I need you guys to let me know when you guys are 100% ready to go before we get this shit started. Over.
2-2 copies and is ready to go. Over.
Good copy, 2-2.
Havoc 2, this is Havoc 2-3, we're good to go. Over.
2-3, this is 2-7, solid copy, over.
You're up on your radio nets, right?
Havoc 2-3 out.
Not yet, no.
Alright, let's do that when you get a chance.
I will be here in a sec. Do they have aviation today? I don't.
Yes. They should. Okay. Fucking Task Force FTX.
Okay, we're all set. Okay.
Two on, ready to go. So that's a no.
F2, this is 2-4, we are ready to go.
2-4, this is 2-7, solid copy, over.
Oh, and to FS answer your question from earlier, Taco, yes, I did put a new goal up. What I'm going to do is, instead of adding a fourth monitor and continuing to tax my primary system, I am going to build a streaming PC, a secondary PC, just to stream. So I'll work on that over the winter, through the goal and through, obviously, my own personal money. And then that goal will end, actually, on my birthday. So hopefully, by spring, the streaming PC will be up and running.
Well, I've got the majority of you here, and I'm yelling so you should all be able to hear me. During the whole of this FTX cycle, and for the foreseeable future, if we experience any negligent discharges, they will 100% under every single circumstance be a disciplinary. Do not ND.
You guys have weapon safeties, you guys condition for your weapons, make sure you guys...
And to, I guess give you guys kind of an idea of what we're doing tonight. Staff Sergeant Munson is primarily going to be Zeus and everything. This is kind of his final night of training for Zeus Operator. So, I'll just be kind of hanging back, putting in, you know, tips and pointers here and there. But he's going to primarily be handling shit. And then he'll be another one of our Zeus operators, so hopefully I'll get to fill in a little more often than what I do now. I won't be stuck just Zeusing all the time.
Right.
Lee, I wouldn't know, bud. I honestly don't care. Makes no difference whatsoever in my life. We have so many people coming into this unit. Doesn't matter.
Sunshine, are you back?
Munson, make sure at your roadblocks and shit, you get rid of the stupid trivial stuff like those little rogue cones and shit. Also, get rid of the bar gates. They look good, but if we try to send a vehicle through them, they'll just drive around them. They won't actually go through the bar gate. Are you hearing me?
Hang on, fucking Lindsay's talking to me.
I will demote her if she continues to distract my Zeus operator.
Okay, what? Sorry.
Make sure at your roadblocks that you get rid of the trivial shit like those stupid little road cones and get rid of the bar gates.
Yep, roger. I'm just trying to get shit down and then detail shit if I have time.
Yeah, we did lose some Zeus operators a while back. We could have, you know, obviously very easily just thrown some people into the slots. We have a very specific way that we like to see things Zeused, at least for myself and Captain Drumheller. So we've taken a lot of time training these guys and going over all the little minute details with them. So that the missions are not only realistic, but they're also fun. That's the big thing for us, is making sure the guys, even when it's a tough mission, still have a lot of fun. I mean, you can get your ass kicked all night, but it can still be fun if Zeus properly. So these guys have gone through weeks and weeks of, you know, watching us Zeus, watching videos of us Zeus and Zeusing alongside of us, to make sure that they're properly trained, and that when we, you know, kind of let them off the leash, that, you know, they're going to do it correctly without us, you know, sitting there watching them.
All right, guys, school circle.
As it is, you know, it's an incredibly important job. I mean, a lot of guys don't realize how vital that role is of a Zeus operator. I mean, they can single-handedly be responsible for an amazing mission or, you know, one of the most fucking miserable nights you'll have.
It is on the squad leaders for you guys to handle that at your squad training. That's unacceptable that people are coming in here with mod conflicts. Every time I see a mod conflict pop up, it pisses me off.
Sergeant Hammer's man is mad.
Because you're holding up people who have done their fucking job and have gotten in here ready to go and have been sitting here waiting for you guys patiently. All right? Next time I see mod conflicts, I'm going to start yelling at people. It's not going to be fucking fun. All right? You're holding up everybody else. With that being said, I'm going to...
He almost sounds as pissed off as I usually do.
For not only unfucking mods and making sure they're done at squad training...
Almost.
But also for handling an operational environment. With that being said, when we have an objective and we want to take something out, it's not the job of Platoon HQ to delegate and exactly micromanage where you guys are going or how you guys are doing it. The focus of today's FTX is going to be having the squad leaders running the entire operation by themselves with no involvement from Platoon HQ. All right? So, what needs to happen on PlatoonNet that I have not been seeing? The first thing I want to hear more than I ever have before is contact reports. We've drilled on this at every level from the fire team all the way up to the platoon.
Nah, he's not pissed. He's just a little upset.
So when
I don't think I've ever seen Sergeant Hammer's man actually pissed.
What do I want to hear? I want to hear the unit. I want to hear the 3Ds. Can somebody shout out to me what the 3Ds are?
Distance, direction, description.
Only two people yelled that out. Distance, direction, description. So involved with your contact report, that's what you need to fucking include. This is who I am. This is what
Sergeant Hammer's man is the nice platoon sergeant. I'm the asshole.
In any order. So when that happens, that needs to go up the chain of command as quickly as possible so that we at Platoon HQ know exactly what's happening and where. That way, if we need to micromanage and we need to send additional assets, whether it be at the company level or the platoon level, over to assist you, then we can do so effectively and quickly. All right? So 3D is distance, direction, description. That's what I want you guys to be focusing on. Another thing is...
Actually, I had somebody tell me last week when I was yelling at some guys about a... yelling at the guys about a negligent discharge that, they're like, you weren't even yelling at me, and I felt bad. I felt guilty.
You need to put yourself physically in proximity to your sister squads.
Hey, Victus, thank you, brother. I appreciate it big time, as always.
Providing Overwatch, etc.
You guys are fucking awesome with all of the support.
Where the other squad is, where the other squads, what they're doing, and how you can...
And you guys probably can't really hear them that well, can you?
Have been constantly working together. I want to hear the entire platoon working together on PlatoonNet today. I'm not going to be holding your hand and doing it either. So you guys need to take the initiative, say who's moving, who's on point, who's going to be left flank, right flank, etc. You guys need to put yourselves in that position. You guys need to do that. That's also a major thing PlatoonNet and that I want to hear. Squad leaders, any questions?
Did stupid shit.
Who's
going to
be coordinating with 4-2?
If the squad leaders...
Why in the fuck did I just hear him over global?
To PlatoonNet, and that's what they're for. But as far as the individual movement of squad...
Yeah, I'm not standing close to him. I mean, captain's standing right in here. I'm over here. Just a moment. I need to see why the fuck it is I'm hearing Burke on global. That's weird. I'm going to have to turn him down. So everybody here...
Prepare to defend yourself! But at least we have it taken care of now.
Yeah.
Same thing with loadouts. I see people running around grabbing shit still. Alright, so the first phase, what we're going to be doing is we're going to be setting up a convoy. Lieutenant Hart will be running the convoy as convoy commander. So we're going to be doing a little bit of a practice. As you can see, we have the route marked on the map.
Yeah, pretty much.
The dismount point, which is marked... with that downward arrow at grid 108002. From there, the platoon will be moving on foot northeast to take out that communications tower. That'll be our first objective. From that point at the dismount point up to the communication tower is where you guys will be doing everything by yourself and on your own. All right? There will be...
Yeah,
there.
They'll be running VIX up to a dismount point, much like we did for platoon training for Havoc 1 just a little bit ago.
So, for a convoy, I want the
which means I will need to get some vehicles out here. Well, no, they can run over and get the fucking vehicles themselves, goddammit.
With that being said, there'll be a command VIC. Mortars, get a command VIC with that's unarmed. And rest of you guys fill in out in front and back of that.
All right, Munson, I'm going to teleport myself over there next to them real quick because they're... Probably in the next 3 mics or so, about to ask me to spawn vehicles, and then I'm going to have to explain to them to go grab their own goddamn vehicles, because we're right there.
Roger. Go.
The 723 will take point, over.
Alright, 2-2 will go next, we can just go in order, 2-3, 2-2, 2-1.
Oh, never mind. Lieutenant Hart's already on it.
Alpha, go grab, get your rifleman, and go grab a Vic for us,
Yeah, they'll have air assets in the air tonight. Captain Soto will be running as Thunder.
Sabre 2-3.
Right. What position are we getting on top of our Vic over Wall tonight?
So if I put my fucking earplugs in, that's where everybody's so goddamn loud.
Break. All squads is Havoc 2-7. Your platoon commander was just calling up PlatoonNet and he's getting talked over by all the fucking squads. Knock it off.
Alright, yes, they will have air assets up. Captain Soto will be up in the A-10 as Thunder, and then, you see, we got, Chief Steves, Warrant Officer Gillett, and Warrant Officer Wade in for Rotary.
Havoc 2-3, be advised, we took a grenade launcher for the first Vic, Havoc 2-2, I suggest you take a GMG over.
Alright, Munson, how are we looking?
Good. Thank you, Corporal. It's coming along.
It's, such a 5-1 on the radio, not on speaker.
Hey, Perm, we're second line, so get right behind, right behind that first Vic you see up there.
Alright, don't forget that other roadblock you got down the hill there.
Yep, I'm just filling, I'm just doing one building with detail in it, that's where I'm gonna put out just a little... officer looking guy.
Alright.
And so far I got
I don't know if Mortars is here tonight or not. I know at least some of the guys are here. I don't know if they're filling in or if they're filling their primary billet. I can live with that.
So what's the order? 2-3-2-4 can go third.
Right.
Now I don't know for sure what uniforms Rotary's going to be in tonight. I don't know if they're strictly flying Phoenix or if they're going to have Lancer or Thunder or Warlord in the air or not. Sweet. I'll just wait until the next update.
Oh, is it going to be pretty badass?
Oh yeah, it's even better. Yeah, absolutely. We're always recruiting. 11 Bravo and 11 Charlie are the two MOSs we have open right now. 11 Charlie being indirect fireman.
Keep going up, all the way up, all the way up.
2-7, this is 2-1.
2-1, this is 2-7, go.
2-7, interrogative. What number is 2-1?
Hey, whoever that is, you're in the wrong spot.
Pick number.
That'd be Williams.
Good question, ask the rest of the platoon. Over.
God damn it.
Yeah, there's plenty of 11 Charlie spots open.
Alpha Bravo.
I do not hear any fucking communication on platoon net. What the hell's happening?
Two seven, this is 2-2. We're loading in now. This is 2-3. We're in Leavig. Over.
Yeah, I actually seen that transfer last night, but and I believe Sergeant Hammers may have missed it because we've had so many guys coming in. But I'll remind him of it when we get done here. I think he just completely missed it with how many guys we've had reporting in and shit. So I'll make sure that gets handled tonight for you, bud. Got Rotary hanging out over here.
How's this Vic?
No, that's Captain Soto, I believe.
Just move up.
Oh, Chief Stevens.
We're loaded up, in line, ready to go.
How's the captain? Oh, he's already in, doing pre-flight. Only you had time for the unit. I mean, obviously, I would try to talk you into it. But honestly, there's varying levels of, you know, the time you need to dedicate. I mean, just to be in a fire team, you know, just like a basic rifleman or something, there's really not that much time you have to dedicate to it. I mean, obviously, to get the full experience out of it, you want to be around. But you don't have to, you know, spend that much time. You have your weekly squad training that's required, which is, you know, 1 to 2 hours, sometimes a little bit more. And then your operation every other week, and then your monthly platoon training. So in a month, you have 4 squad trainings, a platoon training, and 2 operations. So you have 7 total things that you are technically required to do. But I know, at least for Havoc 1, for my platoon, our attendance policy is 3 unexcused or 5 total, meaning you have to maintain just over 50% attendance at minimum. That's really not that difficult to, you know, make 4 events out of a month. Which, obviously, I don't know how busy your life is, but, you know, I'd say give it a shot.
Dagger, this is Phoenix, correction, Lancer 2-2, radio check on frequency 70.
2-1, this is 2-7, so
copy. 5x5 on 70.
Roger that, out.
Yeah, I don't know about a even more advanced flight model. I Captain Soto may fucking cream his pants every time he gets in the bird.
Wrong net, last unit.
2-4, this is 2-2. Are you guys the last one in line?
Right, 2-1 is last in line, over.
I don't know, I'm gonna have to set my radio to convoy net as well.
Elastic left turn.
And Dagger, this is Lancer 2-2.
Center for Dagger on 7-0.
If the comms become a little too much for you guys, just let me know. I've very quickly learned how to. Well, I guess I didn't learn how to have selective hearing. I've always had it, but I can very easily kind of shut off one ear and listen to one thing and talk at the same time and listen to something else in the other ear. So it's nothing for me to listen to four or five different radio channels at the same time.
Pick one, turn it right.
Turning left. 2-4, 7-2-7. That's a firm. We'll roll through contact unless otherwise stated. Right. Over.
Last pick turning left.
Convoy comms isn't too bad. Spacing looks decent.
Pick one, turning left.
Lee, brother, I think we're all innately born with it. Just some of it use it better than others.
Pick one, right turn.
Last pick turning left.
Sit rep, Munson.
Last pick turning right.
Basically done. Flushing out some patrols along the road and yeah.
All right, perfect.
Pick one, wide left.
And I'm gonna put them surrounding that area a little bit, so in the tree lines, rock ridges there, and
yeah, just kind of
coast. I'm gonna put some shit just as you know. A normal
all aviation elements is Dagger 11 and 70. Be advised, we're just north of the solar power plant.
Yep, that's perfect.
East. Over.
Dagger 11 Thunder 61, we got you on TADS.
Lee, I believe you, brother. I may have to get a few pointers from you at some point. Not on the selective hearing, on not getting killed after 50 years. Do we have armed RG-33s? Yes, we do, but we use the MAXXPROs. I actually didn't grab any MAXXPRO pluses tonight. That's actually something that that guys mistake a lot, is that they only refer to these MAXXPROs as MRAPs when technically, both of them are MRAPs, both the MAXXPRO and the RG-33. MRAP is just a designation of the type of vehicle, it's not the vehicle name. These are MAXXPROs, these are RG-33s. Spacing's getting a little spread out on that lead Vic. How would I describe leadership in our unit? I'm already long-winded enough, let alone answering a fucking question like that. I don't know, honestly, bud. That's it's kind of like asking to describe myself, given my positions in the unit. I don't know. I would say no bullshit. You know, we don't really let stupid things slide. You know, we're all friends, and this is a gaming community, but it's a realism unit first and foremost.
Pick one here, moon right.
All right, Munson, I'm going to bring us in closer.
Roger. Fuck, I didn't add them to...
I got it.
Okay. Because I didn't even know they were that fucking close yet.
Yeah, I got it. Don't worry about it.
This is Havoc 2-3. We've got east right, down the road,
little,
over.
Teeny settlement of guys is built up. Got my patrols going. The guys on the rocks are good. The guys in the little wooded area is good. Now I'll just put some shit on the little coastal build-up, and then
hey,
we're good,
I think. Now, be honest, you've never seen my party in the back.
All squads on frequency 120, this is Havoc 27.
But no, yeah, I'd say... I'd say honestly that's true. I mean, we're firm but fair. We try to give people the benefit of the doubt. But, you know, when somebody's just flat out being fucking stupid or unruly, I have absolutely no problem putting them in their place.
And you'll use those vehicles as a force multiplier. Make it happen. 270.
Well, Taco, you were offered the party in the back because of how much money you give me. That kind of comes along with it. Yes, but I would agree, it is a trap. Last one that seen my party now has my baby, so...
That ETR is bearing 083, approximately 1,600 meters out, over.
Damn, they spotted that BTR already?
I don't know. I didn't hear him call it out.
I heard him calling out a BTR, but I don't know which one they're talking about. Oh, yeah, it's the one at the roadblock there, just sitting out in the open.
2-2, I've got eyes on a fire team.
One, this is Dagger 1-1 on 7-0.
Bearing 084, about 1,000
Dagger
meters 1-1,
this is Thunder,
with
you on 7-0, go ahead.
Headed south to north.
You're clear for takeoff on FTX.
I'm not going to add all your units to Zeus just to kind of save on performance a little bit. We're sitting pretty good at 34 frames right now, so again, this is kind of your show tonight.
Departure to the west, altitude at my discretion, maintaining recon over the
3-2
main radio on the way out. Alert start.
Pure Milsom. Bullshit ArmA units.
Roger, alert start.
Half-assed correct. At least from my perspective, there's a very, very distinct difference between Milsim and realism. We are realism. We are not Milsim.
Roger, Dagger.
You know, a lot of the like units you'll see as far as ArmA that do like the special forces, super secret squirrel shit, and have, you know, all kinds of crazy fucking names for their guys and just unrealistic ranks and weapon systems that they would never, you know, carry in real life. That to me is Milsim. They're simulating military experience. As to where we're realism, we try to keep it as realistic as we can while still having fun. Obviously, you know, guys don't want to get fucking screamed at and just, you know, beat the shit out of the entire time and go out on a fucking combat or on a patrol and just walk along the side of a road for fucking 4 hours and not see anything, which is very, very fucking realistic. So we have to walk a very, very fine line with that. We're also not going to make the guys go out and stand in parade square for 3 hours just to have them do nothing.
You know what? I kind of want to put one T-70 just for good measure. Hang on, let me count my armor.
No.
I know. Three. I'll do one more.
Actually, Mackie, I don't even honestly know if that'd be accurate anymore. There's a lot of people here that were never in the 15th. Myself included. There's a lot of fresh blood here. Nope, even myself, I've been here for over 18 months now. I was never in the 15th. Yeah, mop gear. Fuck no. I'm gonna assume there was a hunt IR round I just heard. Yep.
In the radio and the comms
okay.
tower. Over.
That's pretty good.
It's 2-3. Roger that.
2-2 is 2-4. Are you on the north side of the road? I'm betting that military complex right down the road from him is gonna fucking scare the shit out of him.
Dagger, this is.
I'm gonna be like, is there anything in there? You're advising, ready for checking.
Thunder 6-1, this is Dagger
1-1-7-0. 2-3, this is 2-2, we are set. You can bound past us, or 2-1 can bound past
Roger,
us.
Roger, Dagger, Thunder 6-1 with you on 7-0, flight of times 1-8-10. I am 5.5 clicks north of Bullseye in a right-hand racetrack. Ordnance is reading as full load on the gun. 2 times AIM-9 X-ray Sidewinder, 6 times AGM-65 Mavericks, 14 Hydra-70 rockets, 4 times GBU-12 LGB. Abort code will be wave off. I am saddle and laser capable, fuel tanks at 9er. 8% and bleeding.
2-1, 0+9-0,
standing by for your work on 7-0.
Roger, read back to follows on track. You 5 foot north of the AO and a right hand race track.
Alright, I purposely shut the fuck up there for a minute for Captain Soto's check in for you guys. Gives me a hard on every fucking time.
So we have a BTR in the area with surrounding infantry on the top of the ridge.
The fuck?
Looks like we're taking shots.
Or jab out on the BTR.
Roger, Dagger. I copy. Troops in contact. Possible armor and infantry. I'll get the pod out. See what I can find for you.
They're hitting that.
Fuck, you're talking.
Roger,
yeah, it's a click and a half shot.
Maintain altitude at your discretion and provide recon over the task force.
I'm watching.
Over.
Probably just over
Roger,
a click and a half.
Climb and maintain. Angels 2 for now, until we establish if there's any AA in the area and get a better picture down here.
2-1, this is 2-3. Once you guys pass,
Roger,
we're going to be
two.
Rolling right behind you. Over.
Did they launch? I thought they 2-1 launched.
2-1 copies.
Yeah, they did.
I don't hear nothing.
Shouldn't have that long of a flight time.
Yep, so they had a misfire. That sucks.
2-2, this is 2-4. Where are you guys? I don't see an impact anywhere either.
2-4 is 2-2, affirm. We're by that white house on the southern side of the road.
I'm gonna have to turn Burke up a little bit though. Prepare to defend yourself. Even though I'm hearing him over fucking global, I can't hear him at all right now.
Okay, copy that. Two-one, this is 2-3. Be advised, we're gonna push to your north flank. Over. 2-1 copies.
Yeah, that's exactly what it is. My Thanksgiving was good, bud. Thank you for asking. Me and the family went out to my brother's house, met up with all the rest of the family. I had a really good time, ate fuck tons of food. My brother did 3 turkeys this year, 1 smoked, 1 fried, and cooked in the oven. Obviously took home a shitload of leftovers. But it was really good. Got to see all my brothers, which was nice. It's not real often that all 6 of us get together. So that was really nice. They all got to see my baby. It's the first time my brother Travis has gotten to see her since she was born. So that was really, really cool.
2-2, this is 2-1. 2-1 is 2-2.
Did you ever see an impact on that fucking
Jav?
Nope.
Push past you east over.
I didn't even see an impact on the rock. I thought maybe it hit that fucking cliff.
Compound east southeast of us with walls and guard towers. I don't see any men in it, but
Matt Williams is calling out that compound.
Copy that. We'll keep our eyes on it. Okay, we should be able to cover you from here as well.
You didn't want anybody in that little military complex at the
No, nope.
Right? Okay. Just wanted to make sure I wasn't missing something big or something.
Alright, I'm tired of fucking muting and I'm muting my microphone, so you're gonna hear me talking to my fucking chat.
Oh, no,
deal with it.
I'm fine with it.
Where the fuck are we at in relation to them? Taco, again, I appreciate it, bud. You're a fucking nut.
Pushing past 2-2.
Alright, we're at 29 frames, so we're still doing really good. Is Rotary in the fucking air yet? Thunder's in the air, Phoenix is still on the deck. Dagger's calling Thunder right now. Oh, he's calling him in on that BTR. I'm gonna fucking stab him in the neck for calling a goddamn cTab.
Roger, Dagger, I got your BTR on saddle. See if I can find it.
Yeah, I put the well, I didn't put the order in. I called my computer guy, had him put the order in for the liquid cooling rig. So that'll be here hopefully soon, and we'll get that put in. Hopefully in the next couple weeks. The new goal is for a streaming PC. I'm gonna have an actual second PC built just for my streaming.
070 coming.
I don't know who the fuck was just on that radio, but they had their shit on speakers. Frank, I sound like your uncle. I don't know if that's a good thing or a bad thing, especially depending upon his age. Yeah, there's still a long fucking ways out there. I don't know if these guys up here would have even heard that JAV fire. Probably, but I don't know for sure. That's long ways out there.
Yeah, it is.
Copy that, 2-3, 2-1, this is 2-2, we're coming past you right now. Copy that, 2-2. Advising your set, and 2-1 will bound pass. 2-2 copies.
This is kind of a dick move.
This
Havoc
2-3 be advised.
They don't fucking be smart about it. They're gonna fucking die in the fatal funnel. But
there's a what gunner? Oh, I see him.
Was that a jab or a?
No, those were mortars.
Oh. Oh, damn. Well, that was upsetting.
Yeah. Mortar rocked him pretty good. The i7 was... Fuck, how much did I pay for that? I think it was 340. Wasn't that bad. I actually believe, that's what he's getting, is the Corsair H100.
Oh,
I'd have to look to make sure.
Be advised, the BTR has been destroyed, possibly by a javelin team.
Well, if they said I sound like their grandpa, then I would have to pull a Sergeant Major Plumley and tell them if any of them called me grandpa, I'd kill them.
Poses has a great overwatch of our advance onto the communication tower, and will most likely provide a serious threat to the task force.
Yeah, our mortars are very, very accurate with the artillery computer.
Advised on your right, you're gonna have a walled compound as well. I didn't see anybody in it, but that doesn't mean they're not there. Two-one is Oscar Mike pushing past 2-2 at this time.
Thank you.
Dagger, Thunder 6-1, be advised, I have updated the
two
marker on saddle.
He
is at 0645 grid 124044. Marker's exact.
Copy that, 2-4.
Alright, that be advised, troops in contact. Weapon squad is...
We're hitting your guys on the hill.
That's no fun.
Oh, well, in that case, if he's cool, then yeah, it's definitely a lot like me, you know. Alright, first contact, we're at 14 frames, so we should be good.
I forgot to put a mortar.
Should I put a mortar pit down? There's not really much room for it, but...
Hang on.
Just fucking go without it. There's always a fucking mortar pit on every mission. Don't leave it.
Yeah, there isn't really a realistic spot to be putting a mortar down anywhere in there.
Yeah, it's pretty tight in it anyway.
2-3, this is 2-4. Do you want to start maneuvering up? I don't think we're getting, I don't think we're doing much good sitting out here.
Oh, you mean my,
Roger, Roger, sorry, I'm
my intro thing? Yeah.
Drive,
you're welcome.
A bit down the road, just as a quote-unquote spotter, so.
And so this is, honestly, this portion here is going to be fairly boring, guys, because they got a long ways to trek, especially on foot, to get up to this this hilltop here, and it's all just barren, open nothingness. But once they get up here and start actually pushing into this compound, that should be pretty good, because this is one hell of a fucking fatal funnel to get into. So it'll be interesting to see if they dynamically breach these M walls, or at least try to. Either with the with one of the VIX or with some M112s. Do I enjoy Zeusing? Yes and no. I don't like doing it all the time, which is what I end up doing. But that's also exactly why I'm training new Zeus operators. But I do enjoy doing it just to just for the fact that making sure the guys have a good mission and a fun mission.
Mark's already there. Mark is 0645.
I personally don't really care if it's an absolute fucking nightmare for me. It could be the worst night of my ArmA career, Zeus. If the guys say they had a blast, I'm happy. Which I've had that exact situation multiple times. You know, I've had nights where I thought I did an absolute piss poor job of Zeusing. I was very unhappy with my performance and how the AI was and so on. But the guys had a fucking great time, so I was happy with it. Yeah, they didn't make it very far. Who was that that opened up on them? Oh, that was the MRAP with the 50, or with the MAXXPRO with the 50. Yeah, he that 50 tore him a new asshole.
2-1-2-4, we're coming up on your rear from the west.
I forgot that before I sent the poor guy to his death, but anyway, I wouldn't know that until just now, technically speaking.
Yeah. While it was stupid, it was realistically stupid.
Yeah, that's something I can't usually say.
Yeah, the environment is that destructive sometimes. I won't say all the time. There are times where there's walls you can't blow down. And I'm not positive if these M walls can be knocked down. They may or may not be able to. Hopefully we'll find out.
2-3, we're at the northern compounds. We're gaining no contacts. We're continuing on. Over.
Copy that, 2-3. We're south of you. Also negative contact. We're going to push up in line.
2-3, be advised, you guys have better...
Yeah, I know most of the time they can be knocked down, but... ArmA being ArmA, you never know.
In front of us, so we're a better base of fire, over.
2-1 copies.
They chewed that roadblock up pretty good.
Did they?
Didn't kill it. Well, they killed one guy when they hit the BTR. Or actually, that might be a dismount, but...
2-1, 2-4, let's move in together and clear these
buildings. Oh, they killed the, killed the guys that were in the Dishcom.
2-4 will take the north side.
I'm not supposed to do that, goddammit.
2-1 will take the south side.
Guys behind the, behind the bags are safe, though, so...
Outside of that compound to the southeast, facing the objective.
2-1 copies.
Thunder 6-1. Dagger 1-1 on 7-0, be advised the fire mission was ineffective.
Prepare to defend yourselves!
A-frame, go
ahead and keep an eye on that 50 cal, over.
Yeah, the Achilles mod that we've, we've got, and especially with the new update,
ready for a quick intel report.
Does a lot for Zeus. Makes it a lot better.
Send your intel, over.
Dagger, intel is as follows. In the communication tower, there are two times 23mm anti-aircraft cannons on the backs of trucks, markers... 06, 38.
Oh, Soto spotted your Zeus trucks.
There are two BMPs at marker 06.
Where the fuck are, oh, I see him now.
There are two MI8s at 06, Tree Niner, and approximately platoon worth of infantry. There are various patrols around the area, too. All my other markers are down. They should be pretty self-explanatory.
That motherfucker, man, every time he spots that shit.
Two times BTRs and two times Hines on BTR with 14 infantry.
Even if you would have put him under fucking camo netties, he would have seen him.
Correction to that reback dagger. It is two MI8s. They appear to be unarmed. They are marked appropriately. You can mortar those assholes if you want.
Load them with explosives, damn it.
Roger that, MI8s.
And the shitty thing is, they have absolutely no chance of engaging him at all.
Are on trucks, so mortars would be a very effective way of dispatching those.
Thanks, Soto, for telling him exactly.
Roger that. We'll we'll try and take care of them.
No, we do not use advanced repelling.
Any gun strikes on that location would be inadvisable. If there's any risk of fratricide, I won't be able to get close enough to guarantee a really good shot. Missiles and bombs are still good.
Motherfucker, if they clear him hot with a goddamn GBU into the center of that compound, I'm gonna be pissed.
Yeah, that's just gonna kill everything. Here, how about this? I'll move this BMP over here. Move this BMP over there. There we go.
2-1, 2-2, this is 2-4. Are we ready to make maneuvers east?
2-1 is ready to move east. Over.
Did you put down any, Igles? Yeah. Like, Igla troops?
Put down
30
like
minutes,
a
30 seconds away
guys.
From okay. Our base of fire on Hill 82, over.
That's fine. I just didn't know if you had any down at all.
Copy that, 2-3, we'll wait for you.
I got the two AA trucks and maybe two Igles, I think.
Okay, cool.
I'll add a third just, you know, to spite Soto. There we go. There we go.
Oh, you're good, man. I don't mind. Essentially, they're just, pushing up here to take this, comm station. Tonight's a part of our FTX cycle, so they're training on inter-platoon communication and movement. Platoon HQ isn't talking to them on comms. This is all the squad leaders coordinating their movements and who's covering who and so on. Platoon HQ is not giving them direction. And this is a pretty good exercise we've done before. Alright, Munson, we're at 11 now, so don't spawn anything, just keep an eye on shit.
Roger.
If he does drop that GBU, that may cause some issues. Yeah, the frames will bounce all over the place. it's generally the time it'll drop the most is when there's when they're in engagement.
Now discover the small installation.
But as long as it's like 10 or above, or you know, even like 9, it's all right. You can we can live with that perfectly fine. How are they black on Javelin? Didn't they only fire one?
Yeah. What the fuck?
How is
for a world of hurt and it's not my problem.
Yeah, they should. There's no way they can be black on.
Yeah. You got me, dude.
Even if they didn't have a fucking assistant for both their teams, they couldn't be black. Soto's always threatening, you should know that by now. I mean, 2 weeks ago, the guy fucking put 30mm depleted uranium rounds 7 meters from friendlies and did not injure them. Yeah, I'd say he's pretty damn good with the gun. How the fuck, did you say, are they running one Jav and one Maz tonight? Where the fuck is Burke? You over on the left?
Lancer, send your traffic.
No, that's Richie.
If needed, we
no, he's right up front. Yeah, they're running one Jav, one Maz, but still, they only fired one missile.
Roger, stand by, I'll see if I can get you guys clearance.
Roger that.
What are they bringing mortars in on now? Where's that impact at?
Thunder 6-1, Dagger 1-1 on 7-0, be advised. Mortars is currently hitting the southern AA threat on the communication tower. Can you...
And there's the mortars.
All squads.
Holy fuck, those mortars shrek those infantry.
Is fucking talking right now.
Hey,
here, lots of gunfire.
By one, I'll get eyes
what
on
is
it.
Going
be advised, I got a new marker for you. Break. Marker 0-3,
we're starting to push directly.
Fucking mortars.
3-4 are going to be rolling up on a BTR. Sneaky bastards have it in the garage.
2-2, we have an enemy BMP.
Oh, he's in the BMP, that's why he's not responding to me. It's not a BMP, goddammit, it's a BTR.
We
can't
have
fucking stand that.
350 meters southeast of our position.
What? Inside the walled compound, BMP.
Negative dagger, 0656.
It's a fucking BTR.
Roger that. I'm tracking.
Marker's been updated, 0658 on the roof, on the MSR.
Yeah, as he said, former weapons squad leaders, me and Munson. Well, Munson is a weapons squad leader. I am former. So, when guys do stupid shit like that or misidentify fucking armor, it pisses me off quite a bit because that does affect how a weapons squad will engage. If that was a BMP, we'd fire a fucking jab at it. BTR, these guys can fucking take it out with a goddamn AT4, no problem. Munson, if you're still in that BTR, I know you can hear me, but I hope that's not a BTR-70.
What?
2-4, we have...
Oh, are you next to me again? The BTR-70s don't spawn the 70s, only spawn the 60s.
Give me 20 seconds.
Sorry, I completely forgot to mention it to you.
Oh, why? Is it, are they fucked up?
Yeah, they're kind of bugged. Like, everything is fine against them except 40 mics. I had one eat like 20 HEDP 40 mics and laugh at me. But everything else is fine. Like, you can still take it out, no problem with an AT4. There's a Maz. Maz hit, yeah, they're dismounting. It's gonna cook off.
BTR catastrophic.
It's not catastrophic yet, goddammit. Yeah. Please, for the love of God, don't ever do that. Don't call it catastrophic until that fucker explodes.
Oh, yeah.
There it goes. Now we can call it catastrophic.
Dagger Lancer, 7-0.
Advise, I need you to scramble. Clear for parking to the left. Advise, we have a UAV south of task force. Standby, task once you guys are in the AO. Over.
Yeah, they started tearing your shit up pretty good with mortars. Start placing infantry inside that big building or something to protect them. They just scrambled rotary.
On the northern target.
Send the BDA thunder.
Now you need to turn yourself up a little bit though, because for some reason it's hard for me to hear you.
Radar tower is destroyed,
yeah.
And the
okay,
truck. You managed to get it too. Nice work.
Roger that. So the truck is destroyed.
Is that better?
This is Havoc 23.
Sure.
Everything else around it.
Enemy BTR.
Roger that.
We'll
send that off to them. Good work.
Position. Looks like they also got a squad-sized element inside that little village. Over.
2-4 copies. We're killing 2 battle.
We did. Dagger Thunder 6 long. Be advised. The southern.
All right, we're gonna have to move a little closer.
Man, the guns. The wheels are all out on it. They bailed.
I'll take care of it.
Roger that. We'll try and get another fire mission on the.
Yeah, wait one dagger. I'll get you a perfect marker for it, just to be sure.
Position.
2-3 copies. We're holding the fort while you're waiting for your missile team. Over.
He's not getting hammered with IDF. There is no IDF.
They're mortaring the fuck out of my base.
That's what they're there for.
2-4, this is 2-2. We're now southwest of you. We're getting pretty heavily engaged.
The only IDF is friendly mortars going outbound.
702, it is
2-4 copies. Do you have any idea where it's coming from?
Negative. It appears to be coming from definitely southeast of us, but we don't have eyes on it.
2-4 cut.
2-3, this is 2-1.
Dagger, flash traffic.
What the hell are they talking about, IDF?
Rolling out from the compound now. Rolling out from the southern end of the compound.
2-3, this is
2-1. Zenfa 2-3.
Just knock down your own fucking wall, goofball.
East of your pods, moving online towards that village. Over.
Daggers, Lancer.
2-3, say again, over.
2-3, be advised, 2-1, east of your current pods, online with you, facing that village.
Roger, be advised, we're about 3.8 kilometers away from the AO to the southwest. Full load 1300.
Are you controlling it?
Trying to.
Go ahead and control that BTR that's at the fucking northern end of the village there. I'll control the BMP that you just drove out. Or maybe not. Where the fuck did the BMP go?
Full payload south.
BMP definitely drove out of the compound.
Did it?
Standby for cat.
Yeah, he's fucked off somewhere out in the middle of the goddamn desert. That's why I told you to take the fuel out of everything.
I thought I did.
Alright, I'm taking control of it.
Got it.
It's east of the communication tower, 200 meters over.
Correction, 100 meters over.
2-3, interrogative, approximately grid reference 128006, over.
Grid location 128006.
Alright, hopefully I can get this fucker to cooperate with me. These things are a pain in the ass when you're controlling both the gunner and the driver.
Just finished defending Sam at bullseye west 5 clicks.
Whoa!
I would advise you keep Lancer out there.
And that's exactly what I'm talking about.
Maybe a bit risky with man pads up there.
Be advised, BTR in small village at the northwest base of the hill has been gone catastrophic. Over.
That was some nice desync.
2-1 copies.
Nope.
2-1
Jesus
2-3.
Christ.
Be advised, if you guys want to start moving that town, clear it up. We have a good eyes on it for a base of fire. Over.
2-1 copies. 2-1 Oscar Mike. Alright, let's keep pushing north. We're gonna clear out this town. 2-3 is gonna provide overwatch. Let's get on the move.
This is 2-2. We're still engaging some dismounts to our southeast, about 300 meters out.
Stop! Stop! Stop!
Dagger, this is Thunder. God. Priority traffic.
Damn it.
BMP is making his way west now down the MSR off the mountain.
Be advised, we've got a BMP moving down side hill.
Oh dear God. It's flipping.
Bearing 074, approximately 300 meters over.
Fucking things.
Havoc 2, be advised.
All right.
Be advised, that BMP.
Try this again.
Thunder, I need immediate.
Geforce, preparing to get.
I need an immediate hellfire on piece of armor to our west. Danger close.
Alright, well, you disabled the engine and the tracks.
Say again, Dagger, that's to your west?
Correction, to my east. Disregard. Blazing now.
Why in the fuck are you driving that truck up there?
This is 2-2, we're being heavily.
Thunder 6-1, got things out, and rifle on the way. 10 seconds.
Now it's done.
Havoc 2-1, this is 2-3, what's your situation, over?
Did you see that fucking BMP?
2-3, this is 2-1. 2-1 is below Deflate, below that BMP. We are continuing movement north into the town, over.
Yeah, tactical advance.
BTR, catastrophic.
Roger, Dagger, I got eyes on the fireball.
Way to get my heart racing. 2-4, be advised, we are down to 1-AT. Request permission to get an AT-4 from the VIC.
How are they? How are they down to 1 AT, and why is he requesting permission to get an AT-4? Did they not put any extra fucking Moz rockets or missiles in the vehicle?
We're attempting to take it out with an AT-4 now.
Phoenix, this is Dagger on 70. Over.
Station's on 120.
Go for Phoenix on 70.
726. I'm waiting for order to resupply.
Be advised, we need an immediate resupply on the downslope west of our location at 0708. Our task
God, they have fucked this base up.
Over.
Roger that, immediate resupply on Blue Force Marker 0708.
Good read back, I'll be standing by with the green smoke.
What are you talking about? He's being treated perfectly fine.
Be advised, come in low, come in low. We are taking indirect and heavy fire from the east. Thunder 6-1, Dagger 1-1 on 70, what's your sit rep, over?
Well, it's a good thing we didn't put down any mortar tubes, because they've been sat on that hill long enough to fucking build a house.
Now, found a autocannon, UAZ, a couple things around. Standby, I'll get you some good marks for them.
Zabbit 2-3, we got enemies cresting the hill, north side of the
Roger.
Communication hill. Approximately 600 meters away, bearing 060, over.
Pretty decent hits with that Mark 19. You know, a little long there, Jesus.
Dagger on
7-0. Has eyes on enemy
tree
directly
to
your east of the hill, that large rock formation. We're suppressing it, but I don't know if you're...
Alright, Munson, can you hear me?
I might want to watch the shore.
is Lance, sir. Standing by for a CAS mission.
Top green smoke for Phoenix.
Alright, CAS mission is as follows. You're going to come in from the northern shore on, and the fire mission is on 0636. Just hose, a little bit of rockets, a little bit of guns, and then break off to the north. You're going to come in right over
Munson.
Havoc 2-2 and 2-1.
Hop out of whatever you're controlling.
That whole side there, over.
Roger that, we're going
to
be coming
All right, don't send anything more at them. We need to get them fucking moving up that hill, because it's going to take them a while to get up that hill. We're already at 2130.
Yep, I'm just sending the existing guys that were over.
This is 2-2. We're on the south side of the hill. We're still being heavily engaged from a compound that's about 300 meters further south of us.
Roger, 1-3 supply.
Ready, go.
Roger that, 2-3. If Havoc 2-3 moves
That would be epic, except the fucking AI pilots are absolutely retarded.
Affirm, you should be fine moving from your position. It's well past that.
Roger that. I'm going to start pushing Havoc 2-3 up that hill. Looks like this west side of the hill is pretty well quiet, over.
Yeah, copy that.
Phoenix inbound with the resupply.
This is 2-6 on 120. The resupply crate is breaking. Marker.
Still don't understand why they need a resupply already.
0708 out.
Stand by. I am going to. Oh, keep doing what you're doing. I'm going to bounce back to the base and look and see if those vehicles have supplies in them.
Affirm, 2-3 is holding, is resupplying time now.
Also, Phoenix, be advised, you provided vital resupply.
Really?
To the task force, we're all black.
You guys see this, right? Like, I teleported here. I am there.
Be advised, Phoenix just took one times. AA missile, successful.
Ah, it's my life. Player.
Roger that. Lancer, you're cleared hot. I have eyes on you. Coming on for the east.
Yep, 184.
Defending Sam.
All the normal shit.
Four clicks.
And plenty of room for weapons to put rockets and missiles in there. And they already have fucking 7.62 rounds in there, even though it's the shitty 7.62 rounds.
This is Thunder 6-1, be advised, I am back for,
Alright, yeah, I don't know why the fuck they're needing resupply. Every truck has a 184 in it, and tons of room for rockets and missiles.
They are combat ineffective at this time. 2-6 is headed down at that location to try to figure out what's going on.
Roger, Dagger, we're watching the north side slope. We are taking rocket launches from man pads, so... I wouldn't advise any more danger close unless it's...
Not hearing these guys talk too much anymore on platoon net. Got pretty quiet.
This is Havoc 2-1.
There you go.
2-1 does not need resupply. We'll be Oscar Mike south.
What is Lancer doing this fucking close to the AO?
Yeah, this is 2-2. We don't need a resupply. We're ready to move.
Break 2-4 is engaging.
No, it means stop throwing anything at them, since I told you to stop pushing stuff at them so they can push up the hill.
Bring them on over, LZ 0708. I'll be waiting with green stuff to get
up into the this hill.
Yeah, once they're in the compound, yes.
Okay. Dude, I think my fucking BMP in the compound should be an aviation.
Send yeah, laser 2-3.
As it should be.
Can you re-verify targets for north side chaos mission?
I want you to take... Do you still have an Igla trooper alive in there?
0714,
yeah.
Stand by, I'm getting trapped.
I want you to take that Igla trooper, walk him up into one of the towers on the north side, and lock onto that fucking little bird that's sitting out off the coast there,
yeah,
hovering like a fucking idiot. Well, lock onto that fucking little bird and start sending rockets downrange.
2-7, this is 2-1.
They're just sitting there. In fact, I'm gonna fire a goddamn RPG at them too.
2-7, 2-1's vehicle is stuck over. Break.
This is 2-7. Plant demo on your Vic and keep moving up that goddamn hill. Over.
North northwest. Yes.
Well, it's
yeah,
brother, what's the
north northwest. 3-4-5. Pretty easy to see. I'll make that 3-4-0.
Dagger, I'm tracking just 3 times foot mobiles on the north slope of the 0714. That's it. There's
I'm in the radio tower with the Igla. I don't.
Roger,
I'm on the huge
can we get a spray with the miniguns on 0714 and then break off back to the north?
Copy, Lancer 2-3 inbound. Roger, Lancer 2-3 inbound as well.
Oh,
Roger, just spray
rockets,
it, stay low and then
helpful.
Just break off to the north. Nothing too risky.
Dagger, this is Phoenix.
Two one,
I'm currently
2-3, be advised. Wave off, wave off. Directly southeast your location. We're gonna hold at the base of that
rock.
So 2-3
waving out. 2-2 waving out.
At that point, you're gonna be pretty far from us, so I suggest you start moving as quickly as possible. Over.
2-1 copies. 2-1 is currently setting demo on its Vic, and then we will begin movement southeast and following online with you. Over.
2-3, this is 2-4. I'm
780 meters.
Attached to weapon squad.
Lancer, did you guys dispense any ammo?
Negative.
Roger that. We're gonna
call for call
way off here and wait for 2-1 and your elements at 2-4.
All right, looks like they fucked off for a minute.
2-4 cut.
All right. I was just curious because it looked like
yeah, I sat there and looked for them, but I couldn't fucking find them.
It's 2-2. We're
I don't know how the fuck you couldn't see them. They're plain as day, black dots sitting out there in the ocean.
Careful if you're coming up on that hilltop.
Oh, now I see them. I added them to Zeus. Yeah, they're way out there.
Not that far out there. Well, they are now. They were a fucking hell of a lot closer a minute ago.
Okay, Roger. I'm currently 2 kilometers west inbound.
Oh my god, my Igla trooper fell.
Roger that.
Igla trooper.
Yeah, I'm gonna move your one over to this other tower.
Okay.
Same call as last time. It's gonna be 0708. Right on top of the resupply box.
All right, just to give you guys
I have eyes on you.
Quick quick explanation, I guess. The reason I so quickly engaged them out here is that is way too fucking close for an unarmored helicopter to be sitting and just hovering out there. Obviously, these guys at the roadblock would easily be able to fucking see them and call them out. And actually, this guy probably could hit him from there. Possibly. But he would be calling them out, and they would get an Igla up into the tower, and they would most definitely fucking fire at him. So we're actually going to move this guy over here into this tower, because this dude here with the RPG on his back can still very easily fucking see that helicopter sitting out there. So we're going to see if this Igla can get a lock. And of course it doesn't have the actual fucking optics on it.
2-3, you got contacts in the courtyard to our southwest. You direct south to 2-2. We're engaging. Reference our tracers, over.
Yeah, I can't see him because of the fog.
Does the Igla have, like, a special lock-on distance?
Say again.
2-3, this is 2-2, over.
Send up 2-3.
That's us moving.
If you're controlling somebody, Monson, I'm not going to be able to hear you.
Roger that.
I was asking, does the Eagle have like a special lock-on distance or something?
Yes, it has a range.
Like, how far can they be out?
I believe it's like a click, click and a half. Oh, a little bit closer.
Yeah, not that far, relatively.
No, they got to be relatively close.
Do one, two, three,
that's
over.
The one on the right there is like just outside of range. They pulled it back just far enough.
We still got our Vic, and we can't get on this, onto the top of the hill from the north. We're going to have to swing south of these rocks and attack the base, the communication tower from the south. I suggest you join us. Over.
2-1 copies. We'll start falling in on you. Over.
They're grenading the fuck out of that little village.
In approximately 30 seconds. Over.
Orders are outbound. Copies.
Is moving south to the MSR time now.
Yeah, Tunguska's would be absolutely fucking insane.
Break. Smokey's out now, over.
2-1 copies.
Alright, I'm going off comms. One mic, take a piss.
2-1, this is 2-6.
Dagger, this is Thunder.
It's really good.
Just a quick sit rep for you. The only thing I see left in that compound other than infantry is that BMP.
Interrogative, you wanted us to hold.
Roger that, standby. I'll see
that.
Copy that.
Break. We got enemy infantry within danger close on just the near side of this ridge line. Over.
Hey, we're south. We see it.
Having 2-3's got eyes on the compound. Over.
2-7, this is 2-1.
Thunder 6-1, Dagger 1-1 on 7-0, advising run for 9-11.
2-2, this is 2-3, we got men on the wall.
Dagger, this is Thunder,
if you
send your 9-11 ready.
Give a base of fire, we can clear it, over.
Copy that. 2-3, we're gonna come up on the north side.
All right, I'm back on comms.
Catch free control and effect.
Roger that.
South. 4 clicks. Line 4 and A.
I'm calling in a fire mission on something.
0638. No mark. And location of friendlies is 300 meters.
Oh, they're calling in a fire mission on that BMP, center of the compound.
Dagger, this is Thunder 6-1. I read back. Type to control and effect. South, 4 kilometers, NA, 1 times BMP at 0638, no mark. Friendly is 300 meters to the west.
Station 2-4 is taking sporadic
good read back.
Small arms fire. We can't find the source, though.
Fire for effect on
radio. Advise 2-1, fire in the hole.
Roger, Dagger, be advised. I'm going to give this guy guns.
The fuck is 2-1 demoing?
We'll get guns.
Thunder 6-1, tally target.
Roger, tally target, cleared hot.
Roger, cleared hot. We'll advise on final.
2-4, this is 2-7.
Right behind you guys.
Now, if you guys think you're in a position where you can't really do much from there, I suggest you move on, otherwise stay what you're doing.
Thunder 6-1, up and in from the south.
Alright, Thunder's inbound on your BMP.
Fuck you, Thunder.
You can suck my dick.
Yeah.
Where the fuck? We should definitely fucking sing him that sometime.
Thunder 6-1.
Well, where do I have a igloo?
30 seconds
left?
Committed.
Yeah, there's a couple of them in there. He'll take a lock as soon as he flies over. Unless he's doing a GBU.
Roger, clear hot.
Oh my.
2-3, this is 2-1.
Send it for 2-3.
2-3,
nope, he's coming in on guns.
Where the fuck is this man? He's invisible.
And there's the Igla launch. There's the BMP. He's gonna have to go defensive. Oh, he's pissed. He just gave him a full fucking load, too. Yeah, he took a hit. He is pissed.
A beautiful BMP.
I love the attempt.
All stations, this is 2-4. We are going to push up to 2-3's position. We're not getting any contacts back here.
Give you guys a little ride along. I guess I could have done that for the gun run.
Lancer, dagger on 7-0.
Yeah, he's definitely definitely beat up though.
2-2, we are coming up on your southern side right now, southeastern.
2-1 copies, 2-2.
Happy twos, it's 2-3 over.
Yeah, she took a pretty good hit.
Dagger, this is Lancer. Advise when. Standing by for
in possession of ammo cache.
Roger, Lancer, both.
Yeah, Thunder definitely took a hit from that.
Guns, rockets on the western wall of the communication tower and just on the western side of the compound. Make a quick over.
Roger that. Guns and rockets on the western side of the wall of the compound. Inbound. About 30 seconds.
Roger.
Oh, he can lose engines.
Dump shit in there. Just fucking go ham. And then break off to the west.
Roger that.
Holy fucking danger close RPG there, Batman.
This is Havoc 2-3, be advised. We're down 1 minute, over.
Yeah, he got in on a gun run for sure. I am getting a shit ton of desync here, though. What is going on?
This is 2-1, be advised. 2-1, temporarily combat ineffective, over.
2-1, this is 2-2, do you need help?
So
negative 2-2, standby, over.
What's going on here?
Also experiencing issues.
We are looking like the whole server is desynced out here. There it goes. That was fucking weird.
Brewer?
Is this 2-1?
Yeah, the whole server just lagged out.
Was it because of the GBU or whatever on the, or the A-10 strike or something?
I don't know what caused it. That was,
2-1, we are back on fire mission, over.
That was weird as fuck.
Alright, well, I'm gonna delete some of the shit that they've already crushed behind them, so...
Yeah, start deleting a lot of shit. Delete those burning vehicles.
I'm on it. I'm deleting all their little fucking trenches and all that other shit.
Lancer, you guys ready?
Roger, we're still about to take some AA
missiles
progressing from to the west, over.
No, it didn't go down.
They just said it was down. Well. I don't know if that's true.
No, they were asking if it was okay.
Do you guys have any good effect on target? We're experiencing some technical issues down here.
Yeah, roger that. It's a bit laggy. I was able to destroy at least one time. MI8 fired the T-Rockets and got run.
2-2 copies.
Okay, roger that. Good job there, Lancer.
2-3, this is 2-2, over.
Alright, roger.
I don't know what the hell caused that, though. We were holding steady, and then all of a sudden it just dropped.
Roger that.
If you guys go straight east, you can get over.
Back up at 18 now. I mean, yeah, we deleted a couple things, but I don't know. That was definitely weird.
The only thing I see now is, one times UAZ on the north slope.
Over.
got a marker on him. The rest of it's about a squad and change worth of infantry left in the compound.
Let me know when the checkpoint is clear. I have explosives set on those, on that cache. Over.
Stand by.
Well, I guess they don't need to dynamically breach the wall. There's already enough fucking holes in it.
Cork gun's gonna have some fun though. Come on, secret cork gun.
This is 2-4, that checkpoint is
clear. He's not gonna have much fun at all unless they actually come right in the front door, because he won't be able to shoot through the wall. Because the wall that's down, the legs of the M wall are in the way. No, I don't think it was the A-10, because it was too long after that gun run that it crashed. Or that it started to go down anyways.
This is 2-2. We are moving in to the south side of the compound and working our way north. So 2-1, watch for us. 2-2 copies.
Yeah, that's possible with the BMP and then touching off these other three VICs. Should be fragging that entry. Oh, they got him.
Well, at least he got one. That's all that matters.
Dagger, this is Thunder on 7-0.
Center for Dagger on 7.
Yeah, stand those guys in the tower up.
He's got this one squared away. He can't, like, in, head back to Cheyenne right quick. I got Betty shouting at me. I did take a hit from that BMP, and she will not shut up. May need to put it down on the runway and restart this jet.
I fucked that MAXXPRO up.
Like a big old face on Lieutenant Hart there. Just waiting outside of that bunker. Fucking madman.
What's
that rifleman in the middle of the compound by himself for? Do you? Oh, I guess he's not by himself. He's going.
The hell are you talking about?
Is he the dude?
Why is he yellow for me?
Yeah, he was yellow for me too. I was like, what the fuck is that?
Can you delete him? Who the fuck is that? That's not a player. Players are blue.
Hey, Firm, come on in. 2-4, go left, clear up this little, smaller building.
Are you sure that's not a person?
2-4, come control, death, fire,
I don't know how it could be.
It's fucking yellow. Okay, move him over here. Yes, okay. I'm gonna throw him in the water because I tried to delete him and it didn't work.
Be advised, negative.
He's in the water.
On that explosives, we will be moving towards it to detonate it over.
Stand
okay.
by. Where the fuck did he go?
I tossed him in the water.
No, I seen him out in the water. Now he just disappeared.
I moved him farther in the water so no one sees him.
Well, move him back to the land. I need to actually see if it is a person. Jesus.
No, it's not. I can tell it's not.
I shot again.
I added him back.
Four.
He's out there in the water. Oh wait, that's a person.
Tigger, this is Lance from 7-0. Center for Dagger. Tigger, be advised, Thunder head to RTB for repairs. He'll be back on station in 5 mics.
He's just behind Lancer.
Roger, on station in 5 mics.
All right, I'll be right back.
22 is at that northeast tower, so hold your fire. We're going to be moving.
Private Roach, can you hear me?
Holding fire.
Okay, yeah. Definitely not a person. Fuck. That's not Roach, that's for sure. See if I can find the actual Roach. Yeah, I don't know. It says it's Roach, but it's not him because he didn't respond to me.
Two on copies, two on.
How many do you think? Two of them?
Positions on the north.
Two what?
Two BMPs.
Standby.
Roger.
Negative. No BMPs. We're at 2154.
2154 frames.
Yes, Munson, we are at 2154 frames per second.
Well, no, I thought you meant 21 point. Whatever. Anyway, shut up.
2154 is the time, as in 954.
Okay, sorry. Oh, dude, there's still a guy left. Oh, that's stupid.
Alright, I'm gonna move us a little closer. Oh, there's still multiple guys left outside. Let's see, where can I put us? I'll put us down at the bottom of the hill.
Mike is on his paws. This is 2-2. We're securing the eastern side of the compound. We're in a tower in the wall complex just outside the gate.
Roger that. It looks like the east side of the compound is not covered.
2-3. Yeah, 2,000 frames. That'd be fucking amazing.
2-3, we got it. We're on the east side in the tower and in the little walled area.
Correction, my part, west side over. We're gonna take over west side over.
Okay, firm.
This is Habit 2-7-1-2-0. Currently, there's somebody in this task force engaging. I've not heard a contact report for anything yet. What's going on over?
Just 2-4 back up.
Oh my god. How did 2-4 get that? Wait, was that 2-4 that got hit? Oh my god. That was me. On the west side, they got bogged down by that one freaking gunner.
Copy that. 2-3-2-1 SI is on.
Yes! I sat there and shot him at a straight direction. They kept walking in front of the bullets, one at a time. And I'm like, are you fucking for real? Okay. All right, there's, I think, what, one dude left outside? Two left outside? There's one a little ways down the hill farther, but...
This is 2-4, RV is combat ineffective, it's up on some rubble. Do you want us to demo?
Friendly's approach, shooting from the west, over.
This is 2-4. On 120, have got.
All stations, this is 72, index.
Weather dagger, be advised, index, index. You guys can land inside the compound, disembark, and we're doing a debriefing game.
Well, they already called it without me, so...
Dagger, interrogative, do you want me to take these two guys? Apparently,
yeah, because I had a guy fucking shooting at him, and then... Nope. But...
We'll tactically insert you guys.
Alright.
Roger.
That goes for you too, Thunder.
Alright, just to save performance, do you want me to delete some of the little compounds, or leave them for now?
It's all finished. Yeah. Son of a bitch! Yeah, it made my Wi-Fi go bonkers. I had to fucking restart my router. Top again.
Alright, you TPing us in.
No, you're good, man.
Yes. Yes, I do.
2-1 is all here.
Oh. 2-2 is all here. Rotary just landed.
2-4 spread.
Oh, roger.
Dead. Damn it. Yep, I was muted. Sorry, guys. Fucking do that all the time to you.
Steve, you're a legendary creature.
Advise me when you're ready for tactical reinsert.
Okay, we'll get started with second platoon here. Guys were very, very, very rusty at the start again. We really, really need to be communicating better with each other over the platoon that it improved towards the end. But initially, and I think it was the surprise of not having an op-ard.
The guys back at base are ready for a reinsert.
and not having any direction from platoon.
Copy that. Thank you, Tech Sergeant. Also, pass along to one of your pilots. For some reason, I am hearing them over global. Make sure they ensure that their fucking TFAR is up to date.
Ideally, in a perfect world.
Yeah, Roger. I was hearing somebody else on global as well.
Towards the end of this FTX.
All right, thank you, Tech Sergeant.
Exactly what I want you to be doing. I need to focus on diverting, supporting assets, sending you guys in the right direction.
All right, yeah, so we are index. That is index, not index. Index as an end exercise.
You guys,
but yeah, that's going to be it for the FTX tonight.
Kill stuff, fire maneuver, and just get the job I've asked you guys to do done without me giving you very much input at all. So we need to keep developing the initiative. There were occasions where I felt I had to step in and just encourage you guys to think outside the box, to be ballsy with the other squads, tell the other squads what you need to do, what your situation is, and work together. We gotta keep working on this, guys. This isn't gonna go away unless we improve on it. Contact reports were few and far between. That's something we're really gonna have to work on. What I did see as a positive was I enjoyed the way you guys really used Blue Force Tracker to the maximum today. That was really good. There was a lot of marks going down there, and squads were really communicating with each other well through that means of communication. That was very good. I'll applaud you guys on that. You all have the ability to request a fire mission, and you know you may not get that, but more often than not, I will review it and sort that out for you. If you guys need help, don't be afraid to ask.
Motivational speech? No, it's a debrief based upon how well their performance was in the operation we just did.
Ask me for a fire mission.
Good old time's sake, you know.
In the end, I didn't give you one because you didn't ask for one, but I would have given you one. I could see them shooting.
Fuck that is, but God damn it, it's annoying.
And I knew you knew that they were there as well. Let's remember that we can use our supporting assets, and you can ask for them. They don't always come from me to you like presents. You can demand them off me as well. On the field, we're pretty slow moving up to this objective. Very slow, but in that we were very careful at the same time. Did any squads take any casualties?
We all took casualties in KIA.
Do we have any KIA?
Not 2-2.
Negative from 2-1.
None 2-4.
None 2-3.
Right, so that's good. I was wondering if any had been killed and I'd not had an ace report or anything like that. So that's good. Always keep me apprised of your situation. You guys were good with the ammunition 2-4. Good call. Asking for a resupply, that was with you within 5 minutes. And so just let me know, always, if you're in contact, let me know what you need to get the job done. And if you can't,
well, that's
the
entire purpose of what it is we do here.
And
it's a realism,
you know,
unit.
As a platoon, as a task force,
a lot of the guys you see standing
now
around me and amongst me right here are prior and current military from all over the world.
Thank you, LT.
But it's not for everybody.
The biggest thing I saw from a task force level today was lack of motivation and violence of action. There was absolutely no violence of action or no tempo.
But we have guys in this unit that are former 101st. There's guys in this unit that are former 1st 506, 101st. That's the exact unit that they were in real life.
Yes, there was sporadic contact. There was a lot of information being relayed up on Blue Force Tracker for the entire task force to engage, but I don't really know what the hell was taking so long to get up to Hill 8-2 to get eyes on this objective. We were sitting in the open for a very, very long time. We were sitting there without going anywhere, and I had to go around to multiple squad leaders and go, hey, that hill looks pretty good. Why don't we go up there? And then they're like, okay, and then nothing happened until the very end when finally I talked to someone, and they're like, okay, let's go. Finally. I have a lot of notes on platoon level that I want to talk with you guys after this. A lot of notes. And
Yeah, we have guys from all over the place in this unit. Guys from the abandoned UK military, Swedish military, Brazilian, all over the fucking place.
But I think all of a sudden for everybody here, and that now that we're out of deployment and now that we're in the FTX cycle, that everything has kind of slipped and that we're just on vacation lazy mode. And it's unacceptable. And so I have a lot of talking to you with the squad leaders and with the platoon as a whole so we can fucking fix this. That's all I have, LT.
Okay. So that's all we have regarding this. I hope you guys have identified some things to work on with your squads. I'm just going to go to the other supporting assets. So, what are those today?
I got a couple things.
Captain?
Tosco, please stand up. Where'd you get the bipod?
The box.
It is not for you. It is for the DMs. Do not take it again. If it's part of your loadout, remove it.
Understood.
The big thing, thermal scanning. This is for squad leaders.
Yeah, I highly recommend it, man. Steam actually has it on sale right now, I'm pretty sure. ArmA, or the whole package of ArmA is on sale. So you can pick it up fairly cheap right now, this and the expansion.
Targets, especially when you're like, where the fuck are we getting shot from? That's your cue always to take out your thermal optic and scan and help your teams out or walk fire in on a target. I personally heavily encourage the squad leaders to carry their own thermal optics and to use the MX2, not the thermal scope. If you're not comfortable with it, that's something you need to get over and something you need to practice with, because you should be at all times. That's one of your primary responsibilities, is scanning with those thermals and calling out where the targets are to your guys. So get used to it. And just do what you can to get better with it and get more comfortable with it and to scan and to call out targets to your fire teams. That's all I have.
Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
Let's go to Delico. Sorry that we didn't get to do the rest of our training here today. You'll have to speak up, Warrant Officer.
Nothing for the level here, sir.
Thank you. 74th.
Nothing on our end, Lieutenant.
Havoc 4.
Yes, and we got to requesting fire missions. Even if you're not, you know, in heavy contact, or if you really need it because you're taking a big pounding. But, you know, just if you see, okay, there's a compound up ahead, a military compound, we could clear it as we are, you know, we're a full squad and it's a small compound. At that point, it can also be like, hey, can we get a fire mission, something like that? Just to soften up the targets, you know, make it less risk for you to get in there. So that's something to keep in mind as well. That's all I had, sir.
Thank you, Alex, for.
I'll speak to that. That's also for you guys in Havoc 4. If you see a good target, you need to call it up the chain of command and say, hey, we see this target, can we hit it? And it might get turned down, but a lot of times you guys are going to be able to see those targets of opportunity, and since that's your primary job, you're going to be thinking, hey, we can hit that with mortars. The fucking rifle squads aren't necessarily going to be thinking about that, so you need to go, hey, we can hit that with mortars. To whoever the task force commander is, whoever the JTAC. Was there a JTAC here tonight?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So you guys say, hey, we see a good target. Do we have permission to hit that?
Can confirm that was going on quite well today.
Okay.
Fire missions were, I would turn down quite a lot of them today because I wanted to make the second platoon really, really fight for this objective. But yeah, communication was good with Dagger as well, on a whole. Do we have Zeus around?
Affirm, Lieutenant.
Do you have anything for us?
Yes, sir. First and foremost, and most importantly, did you guys have a good time tonight?
Oh,
outfucking standing. The only thing I want to mention is an apology right towards the end there. I know everybody experienced that huge fucking desync. Not exactly positive what that was, but it's looking like it was kind of a freak accident between when the A-10 did the gun run on the BMP inside the base here. That BMP cooking off set off three more vehicles in a chain reaction all at once. And it really fucked with the server between that vehicle going off and then setting off the other three vehicles. So that was a bit of an oversight on our part, and I'll apologize for that. You guys had some pretty shitty issues there for a few seconds, and I was worried the server was going to come down. Luckily, it did not. But that is all I have. Thank you, sir.
Thank you, Zeus. I'm going to open this up to everybody here, so comments and questions. Let's have let's get everybody out of here. You're all dismissed. Second platoon down to the second platoon channel, please.
All right, that's gonna be it, guys. That's the end of FTX cycle 816, and that will be it for the stream tonight. We will pick back up next weekend, possibly Saturday. I will either be filling in for Task Force Charlie or I'll be Zeusing it, not real sure yet. And then Sunday, obviously, I'll be filling my primary billet as a platoon sergeant for 1st Platoon. May stream a couple days during the week, I don't know. But that's it tonight. As always, thank you guys for all the fucking support. You guys are fucking awesome, as you are every other night. And see you later.